we are heading towards destruction and perdition. So for me, I will continue to talk and I'll continue to advise our friends. Yes, talk, write responsibly, but nobody should ask you not to use the basic tools of your profession. It's like someone asking you to tear your certificates. You know, Twitter is not owned by any country. It's a private enterprise. The choice of the president to join Twitter was also personal. It had nothing to do with the people of Nigeria, and he used it effectively, and I used it with him effectively to promote him in 2015. And I still use it almost on a daily basis to promote the activities of the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. I'm sure as at the time he ran into problems with Twitter, he must have acquired maybe over 4 million followership. I have acquired 1.6 million followers, which took me about 12 years to acquire. Nobody can ask me to wipe it out in one day. It's the tool of my job. The president has the freedom to delete himself voluntarily from Twitter, but he cannot delete 40 million others from Twitter because we don't work for the presidency and he does not own us, and he cannot curtail our freedom from doing our jobs to the best of our abilities. So if we all become jobless, are we going to be employed by the federal government? The answer is no. So I am surprised that anybody could come up with such atrocious proposition. For me, it remains a proposition. It's unfortunate, and I believe that some people, the hawks of government, we always have them, have misled the president into thinking that Twitter is the enemy of Nigeria. Twitter has liberated a lot of young Nigerians from poverty, from penury, from frustration, from disillusionment, and this can only compound our problems. My advice is that the president is free to delete himself off Twitter. His family can do it. Those who work for him can do it in solidarity with the president. But we don't owe a president our absolute loyalty.